This is one of the hottest, driest places in the world. But every so often, this barren, seemingly dead place turns into this. But how does one of the most inhospitable environments in the world suddenly transform into a paradise of color? In Southern California, wildfires tend to pop up every year. But some years, the show is so off the charts, it can be seen from space. This is a so-called superbloom. What's amazing is the seeds that spawn all this color may lay dormant in the soil for years, waiting for just the right conditions. You see, every seed contains a food supply, and buried inside is a fertilized embryo of the plant that it'll grow up into. So how can a living embryo survive suspended animation in a place with such extreme temperatures and so little water? Well, the seed's coat is a big reason. The tough exterior protects the seed from bacteria and physical damage, but it also keeps gases from going in and out, which slows down biological activity until conditions are just right. And inside the tough exterior is a sticky layer that keeps the seed from drying out completely, and it even helps with DNA repair. When the time is right, the seed coat sends chemical messages to the seed's interior and allows the right mix of water and oxygen to permeate the seed. The embryo's cells begin to divide, and germination begins. Turns out seeds can wait a long time. In fact, the oldest seeds ever germinated were dormant for about 32,000 years. They were from this plant and were buried in frozen permafrost, I don't know, maybe by ice age squirrels. Despite that long sleep, the seeds germinated and grew into plants, flowers, and all. California wildflowers don't have to wait quite that long. Superblooms have been popping up every few years. Climate change has brought years of heavy rain followed by exceptionally dry years. That variability might mean there are more superblooms in our future, or it might make them harder to predict. But I think we all hope it means they won't disappear. Like this video? Follow PBS Terra for more.